Yeah, I'm the huge Gary to Tankuba, remorseless king of the desert. Who dare set foot into this, my palace of the sands? Speak and be known. Be gone from this place now, or desire will befall you. Yeah, somehow I don't believe that. Hello everybody, it's mardiman641 here, and welcome back to my Let's Play of Paper Mario. This is part 19, and we are in the second dungeon of the game, the Dry Ruins. There's a safe block in here, and now we need to enter our first room. In which case, we come across a new enemy, which is a dark Pokemon, which we'll tackle in a few moments. But right now, let's go down here, and we're gonna pick up the Ruins Key. And then we're gonna quickly go up and get in here. I'm ignoring the enemy for a little bit, but right now, I have to get this set up. Hit the switch. Let's go in here. And then we stand here, we blow this up, and now we gotta fight our next enemy, which is the, what is it called? A Poke Mummy, that's what it's called. So, we grab our hammer ability. Both Pokies are basically dead, and now they are hidden within coffins. Better watch out, and please pay respect for the dead. But, they're not much of a threat either. They're really easy. But wait, there will be more eventually. But also, this one is guarding a badge, and I'm gonna fight this guy if I... Here, I'll just hammer it. We continue! And yes, reused battles will be cut out as usual. But we also get the Spike Badge, which I'm actually going to equip. I'm gonna take Speedy Spin off. But is it enough to attack the Spikes? Spike Shield? No, it's not. Let's take out another active badge. Here, I'm gonna take payoff off, I guess. Oh, wait, I'm supposed to re-equip the badge, dang it. There's spike shield on. We also have enough for one more thing, and I'm gonna buy the quake hammer, actually, because I need to use that. And, oh, pff. There we go. Okay, so now let's go down here. Fool! You have ignored my warning, haven't you? You fool! You will fall into my legions and become a mummy of the sands. Yeah, right. Okay, so anyways, let's go up here. And we're also gonna tackle a new enemy. We got Paracuri, by the way. We're gonna tackle a new enemy here. Which is called a Buzzy Beetle. These enemies are really good at defense. Even if it's a really strong attack, so I suggest you jump on him. And also, the timing of when to block against a shield attack, unlike regular Koopas, are a little bit harder for them. It's a little bit difficult to aim for the right timing for these guys, at least. But otherwise, they're just a little easy. Okay. technically a freaking bomb bay. There we go. Let's hit the switch. But it also reveals a star piece. Jump down here. And we also get a runes key. So let's go down deeper. And you can go right if you want, but it's a dead end. We can see there's a gray block, and we can't do anything about it. Okay, so we're in this room. That's why we need to hit the switch, although we can't do anything about it right now. Before I do anything though, let me heal up real quickly. Because I have a bad feeling about this one. With this, and all of a sudden, my Pokies appear, three of them, and they're all Magnetory, by the way, so I'm going to show all of them. So, like, those things are pretty much trapping you at this point, so we pretty much have to take care of them no matter what. So I'm just going to have to use the Quick Hammer. And I'm just going to use regular bomb, by the way. But I'm not going to make it a big explosion, I'm going to make it a small explosion. Also, if you do not block that, you're going to end up being poisoned. You don't want that. Alright, now also the remaining ones, I highly suggest what you do is that you use Bomb Betty at a distance. And try to trick him. At least try to trick him. It's possible. There we go. But also within doing so, now we have to cross another enemy to fight. And believe it or not, the Quick Hammer can actually hit it. But I highly recommend just switching to Paracarry for this one. And we're gonna use Shell Shot. We will fight this guy again, by the way. And we will show a much better demonstration of what he does. So I approach, then activate the bomb. Does it hit him? No, it didn't, so I have to back off a little bit. Did it hit him? No, it didn't, so I have to do it again. Please hit him. There we go. So what I'm going to do instead is I'm going to use Quake Hammer. Give a much better demonstration of what this thing does. I'm going to switch to Paracarry, by the way. Oh, I can't believe I didn't get poisoned. When he attacked you like that. You must use your hammer. And from him, You can also do anything, actually. You can just jump. But, I didn't push A at the right time. But also, here's another thing that this thing can also do. It can increase your defense, so that way, if he attacks you, it may not do an effect at all. Or, it will increase your defense, however, if it's an enemy that is overpowered, you will only take less damage, but not all damage. And we get a key. We enter the next room. But we're gonna go up here. Oh wait, I don't need a switch. Wait. Come on. Don't go in that room. Flee now while you still can! If you continue, you will feel a horrible curse! Oh, I have no idea why he started acting like this and all of a sudden it starts off with a completely different voice. I don't get it. But anyways, we have a puzzle to solve, by the way, and it involves those switches. You must hit the green one first, then you must go up here. You must go over here. And then you must hit this red switch. But then you also have, afterwards you have to go through the whole entire puzzle again, just to get over there. Well, actually not the whole puzzle, but at least... Well, actually, you don't have to. Because you can just simply do this. But also, don't go all the way down. I suggest you go around the edges, go up here, tilt to the right a little bit, then go left, go down, and then you go right, left. In which case, there's a hidden room with a chest, and you open it. You will get one of the useless badges of the game, the Slogo badge. Makes Mario unable to run, his place becomes very slow. I honestly have no idea why this badge exists. And you know what's even more reasonable? You don't need any points to do it. It's zero, you can do it for free. And what does it do? It makes you walk slow. Very, very slowly. But within opening this chest, we get the Super Hammer! The attack power of Mario's hammer is increased! On top of that, you can now destroy stone blocks! Yay, we made more progress! But now, I am going to walk slowly to the end of this episode, so... See you guys in part... 20. And I'm gonna walk very slow to show how notorious this badge is. Slow.